It's been a big year for Charlie Brown and the rest of the cast of the beloved cartoon Peanuts. 2015 is the 65th anniversary of the Peanuts comic strip. Also, the new Peanuts movie comes out November 6th. That very same week, a book called A Charlie Brown Religion is also set to release. The book focuses on one of the most intriguing topics that Charles Schulz approached in his work, religion. And with us now is the author, Stephen J. Lynn. Thank you so much for joining us, Stephen.
Oh, thank you. This is fun.
Awesome. Well, first of all, what's this book about and why do you want to write it?
The book is a new spiritual biography of Charles Schulz, the creator of Charlie Brown and Snoopy. And I've been a fan since as long as I can remember. And if you were to tell 12-year-old me that I got to write this book, 12-year-old me would not believe you. And so the book really is an opportunity to explore just what was Charles Schulz's faith like and just how often did he put it in Peanuts and how did he get away with it?
It's amazing. And you say that he was a misunderstood believer. Expound on that.
So Charles Schulz is an interesting character who has been labeled both as an atheist and a fundamentalist, which not too many people can get both ends of that spectrum. And he kind of wasn't either. He had a really deep personal faith. But one of the things that I've really enjoyed doing in the book is working through what are the complexities of this very personal, studied believer.
Amazing. Well, this December is also the 50th anniversary of A Charlie Brown Christmas. I love A Charlie Brown Christmas. Mm-hmm. Can you share a short story behind this heartwarming cartoon?
Sure. A Charlie Brown Christmas actually started from failure. They tried to make a documentary about Charles Schulz's work drawing the comic strip, but they couldn't sell it. But a few months later, they got a call from one of the ad agencies who had liked the idea of animated Charlie Brown, which they had just for a little bit in the documentary. And they said, well, could we maybe do this as a Christmas special? And they said, sure, no problem.
Amazing.
Even though they had never thought about it before.
Wow.
So they put together a short story based upon the idea of a small Christmas tree. And then Charles Schulz decided, you know, if we're going to be talking about Christmas on television, we have to be talking about the birth of Christ.
Wow.
We can't not have it. But his business partners said, I'm not so sure that we can do that.
Mm.
And in fact, when they did show it to CBS, CBS said, this Bible thing scares us. Because in the mid-60s, television was still unsure about can we or can't we talk about religion. And Charles Schulz's answer was simply, if we don't do it, who will? And so they did, and it's a classic.
It's a total classic indeed. Well, just around the corner is Halloween, and we're already seeing everything that's closing in on that. How does Charlie Brown's The Great Pumpkin story, which is another favorite of mine, tie in to what we've learned so far about Charles Schulz's religious ideas?
One of my favorite things in writing the book was writing the pumpkin chapter right after the Christmas chapter, because I really see the two as kind of working hand in hand.
Mm-hmm.
In A Charlie Brown Christmas, we see Charles Schulz saying, I believe.
Yeah.
And in It's the Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown, we have him saying, but maybe there's some things to question as well. And so The Great Pumpkin has been a really kind of focal point for folks wondering, what does Charles Schulz really believe? And I see it as being a point where he says, you know, there are a few more things that we should think about than just taking our faith at surface level. It should be deep, it should be personal, and it should be thoughtful.
Awesome. Awesome. Before you go, you actually got a chance to meet Schulz, his family.
As
you gathered material for the book. What was that whole experience like?
It has been just fantastic. His family really, they're diverse. They're unique characters. He has 5 children, but they all really seem to share the spirit of generosity that Charles Schulz seemed to have. And so they've been very warm and supportive over the years and have said nice things about the book, which I like. but I have just thoroughly enjoyed spending every minute with them. They've opened up their homes to me. They've shared photos and stories and letters that have really made the project more worthwhile than I could have ever asked.
Amazing. I can't wait to read the book.
Oh, thanks.
Where can people find the book?
So it is available for pre-order now, and the first week in November, it will be released in stores, all your big box stores. You can find it online as well, Barnes & Noble, Amazon, all the usual suspects.
Excellent. Stephen Lynn, thank you so much for joining us
today.
Oh,
thanks so much.
Awesome.